Have you ever wanted the power of an Xbox console in your backpack? Microsoft and ASUS have teamed up to make it a reality. Say hello to the all-new ROG Xbox Ally X. We tore down the ASUS ROG Ally 2 years ago and we were impressed by how easily repairable it was. So, we're expecting to see a similarly repairable design with the ROG Xbox Ally X. So, can we change a dead battery? Can we swap out some sticky buttons? And most importantly, can we upgrade that 1 TB of stock storage? Let's start this teardown and find out. First up, 8 Phillips screws stand between us and the inside. That's going to be a theme throughout. For this teardown, I'll only need this one Phillips bit, which makes disassembly that much easier. With the screws out, the back cover lifts away, and after disconnecting the paddle button flex cable, I'm greeted to a very hefty looking battery front and center. Let's disconnect that battery before going any further to prevent any accidental damage to the console. 5 more screws and the whole battery tray lifts away. That's a much easier battery replacement process than the Steam Deck or any of the Nintendo Switch handhelds. The battery is rated for 80 watt hours, which is a nice capacity for a handheld. It's even bigger than some laptops we've opened lately. It only takes one screw to remove the M.2 drive, a quick and easy removal. With a lot of popular AAA titles topping 100 gigabytes apiece, that stock 1 TB of storage might not be big enough for your gaming appetite. No big deal, thankfully. You can easily swap in a larger M.2 SSD before you even boot your Xbox Ally X. We have multiple storage options that work perfectly with your Xbox Ally X, so head on over to our store to check them out. We'll have a link in the description. I'm gonna pause the teardown and reassemble everything so I can show you the M.2 upgrade process. Each time you disconnect the battery, the console is gonna need a little help waking up. Plug it into the mains power and with an empty SSD, it'll boot straight into BIOS. From there, press the Y button to switch to advanced mode, tap right to go over one tab, then tap down to select cloud recovery. Follow the prompts and let it crawl through the reinstall. We'll warn you now, this part is glacial. The physical swap is easy, the cloud recovery will eat up your afternoon. Just like the previous gen devices, the user interface on the ROG Xbox Ally X is still Windows, and that can be a real pain to deal with at times. Updates and drive upgrades are one of those times. But other than that, the upgrade process is extremely straightforward. I've taken the new drive out for safekeeping and we're gonna dig a little deeper. On the right hand side, I'm going to disconnect the ribbon and trigger cables, then remove 3 screws holding in the joystick module. These are potentiometer sticks, not Hall effect, which is disappointing since pots have been shown to be very susceptible to drift. If these are like all the other potentiometer based joysticks we've seen, lots of people will start to experience drifting joysticks within 100 hours of playtime. But unlike the Switch 2, where a drifting Joy-Con might mean a lengthy repair or a new Joy-Con, the replacement of sticks in the ROG Xbox Ally X is relatively straightforward. And with that ease of replacement comes the possibility of TMR or Hall effect upgrades sometime in the future. The process is similar on the left side, with the screws holding the stick module down. The triggers themselves come next, and I need to remove these before I can access the next component you might want to pop out for a quick clean, the fans. I've got one more screw and a bit of tape, and once the cables are disconnected, the fans come right out. It's always nice to see modular fans that aren't attached to the heatsink. Next up, I'll tackle the left side button board, which is also modular and held in by 2 screws and a flex cable. The rumble motors are next, each held down with 2 screws and a small metal plate. A quick pry with my spudger frees the left one, and the right one comes out just by tugging on the cable. Though maybe don't do that, use a pry tool instead. The speakers are last on my list of modules. I have 3 screws per speaker, each mounted on a vibration soaking grommet. With these removed, I can disconnect the connector on the mainboard, and to remove them fully, I also need to pop the coax cable running to the wireless card, which unfortunately is soldered to the mainboard, so pray it doesn't fail. Now it's time for the mainboard. I'll disconnect the display cable from both the board and screen side, then remove 2 screws from the bottom corners of the board. That fully releases the board, which lifts up and slides out. There are 4 screws securing the heatsink to the system on chip, and note the numbers in each corner if you find yourself reassembling these. Underneath is the AMD Ryzen Z2 Extreme, an impressive piece of silicon for a handheld. It reportedly delivers higher performance at lower power draw when compared to the previous Gen Z1 Extreme. On the reverse side of the mainboard, there's 4 6GB SK Hynix LPDDR5X modules totaling 24GB, which is double the RAM in the ROG Ally X. The remaining shell houses LED lighting around the sticks, a flex cable for the power button, and a screen that's firmly glued in place. We didn't separate the 7-inch 1080p display from the housing. It's doable, but likely designed as a single service module. So there you have it, a very accessible and easily removable 80 watt hour battery, socketed 2280 NVMe for storage, modular sticks that are easy to replace, though cursed with the drifting spell, and a one Phillips bit fits all design that makes service and repairs a breeze. This handheld is a pleasure to open, though it's not without its flaws. First and foremost, I wasn't able to find any repair guides or spare parts for this console, but having said that, it is early days and I do hope that ASUS will follow through and release these to the public. If they don't, a repairable console is going to count for very little if we don't have the parts to fix it. The screen is also a little bit of a concern. If people are throwing this thing in their backpacks, there will be lots of scratches and broken screens. Time will tell if being attached to the housing makes that more expensive, but we're betting yes. With all of this in mind, the ROG Xbox Ally X earns a provisional repairability score of 7 out of 10 on the iFixit repairability scale. And if you want that 4TB drive, you'll find it in the iFixit store, along with everything you need to keep your gaming gear in top shape. There's room for improvement here, and ASUS and Microsoft can nab themselves some easy points by releasing those repair guides and parts.